Dearest mother. Well, I'm back. Again. Can you believe we are already into the third month of our Lord's year 2023? And with the arrival of March comes the return of my month-long celebration of Back to the Future. You'd know that if you ever took an interest in me. This being the third year of merriment and mirth means that I am watching and discussing the third talkie in the motion picture trilogy, the appropriately named Back to the Future Part 3. Why do I do this? Do I do it in a garish attempt to gain my parents' attention? To show them, hey, I may not have given you grandchildren, but look at all these podcasts I made. Alas, I know you don't listen to my podcast, Mother. And Father, he hasn't the foggiest notion of what a podcast even is. No, no, no. I do this for me. I do this for me and the thousands, the dozens of people who value such an unnecessary and yet very necessary production. I do this for the fans of movies, the fans of comedy, and for the fans of people who maybe didn't make it in the world of male modeling, but dag nabbit they tried. I do this for them, but mostly I do this for me. So Mother, if that is your real name, listen, don't listen, it doesn't matter. It won't stop me from coming back every day this month to celebrate the end of an era, to celebrate the final Back to the Future film. Hugs and kisses, your son Michael, March 1st, 2023.
Come along with me, celebrate year three. It's Marchy McFly again. Back to the Future 3, a month-long podcast with me. It's Marchy McFly, it's Marchy McFly again. I'm doing it again. I couldn't stay away, I confess. Another adventure with Marty and Doc, and this time they're in the OS. So come along with me, celebrate year three. It's Marchy McFly again. Stay here all month long and get sick of this song, 'cause it's Marchy McFly, it's Marchy McFly again. It's a 31-day podcast where I celebrate one movie, and the movie happens to be Back to the Future Part 3.
Da 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 da. Happy March, everybody, and welcome back to Geek Mentality, and welcome back to Marchy McFly. Okay, I gotta stop. Oh, I am so pumped. I am so excited. I am so tired, all wrapped up into what is sure to be an exciting month of Back to the Future 3 podcasts. Every day in March, I'll be watching Back to the Future Part 3. And every day in March, I'll be podcasting about Back to the Future Part 3. Back last year, I did Back to the Future Part 2. That's kind of how it works, if you don't know by now. And I remember talking to a frequent guest of the show, Jay, who I mentioned to him in December. He's coming back. So, Jay, if you're listening, get ready. You're coming back. There's no, like, there's no cocaine in this one. Now, there was no actual cocaine in Part 2, but Jay definitely found a reason for there to be cocaine in that movie. And I hope that he finds something exciting in this movie. I don't know if it's as exciting as cocaine, but my point being, when I talked with him, I think we discussed that 3 is just a superior movie to Back to the Future 2. And after one viewing, I will have to say, yeah, it is. And this is called Back to the Future 3 and Me, because I want to kind of talk about my history with this movie. And I feel like I owe an apology to this movie. You see, this is the one that I watched the least amount growing up. And when I did watch it, I feel like I'd always fall asleep before Marty even made it back to the Old West. My first knowledge of this, so this is 1989 when Part 2 comes out, and I am aware of them being a Part 3. I think I knew at this point. I was kind of like already nerding out on movies and getting magazines about movies, and my brother had a subscription to Fangoria. This wasn't a Fangoria-type movie, but it was that type of thing where I loved learning about behind the scenes with movies. And there was no internet, so you really just had to do it with TV specials and magazines. And I think I was very well aware of there being a Part 3 at the same time, coming a year later. And I remember seeing that first shot of the old West Hill Valley at the end of Part 2 and being like, oh my God, like they've already made it. I didn't even realize that it was possible to make a movie, just sit on it like that. That was the exciting thing, is that they made 2 and 3 back to back. I don't know if 3 was completely done, but it was done enough to get a great trailer. It was probably done. And then, of course, I bought the box set. I saw it in the theater with my brother. I feel like there were a couple of other people with us, but I know for sure it was my brother, because we went to movies like crazy growing up. I have another podcast I'm doing right now called Slash Horror, and there isn't one movie that I've seen in the theater so far that I didn't see with him. In fact, I think just about every movie that I'll be covering, if I've seen it in the theater, for the most part, I can only think of one that I didn't see in the theater with him. But if I saw it in the theater, but if I saw it in the theater, mostly it was with him. Anyway, my point is that we went to see Back to the Future 2 together and a Back to the Future 3 together. He was, okay, so Back to the Future, 1990. At this point, he is 17, so he has a driver's license. So we're able to go to movie. Once he got his driver's license, it was like, game on. You know, we didn't drag race. We didn't go out partying. We went to movies on matinees on Saturdays with our fanny packs filled with double cheeseburgers and cans of soda that we smuggled into the movie theater. They probably didn't give one care about it, but that's what we would do. And that's what I don't know if we did that for Back to the Future 3, because we may have been with other people and we didn't quite go all nerd out when there were other kids with us. But I saw this in the theater and I remember enjoying it, but I don't think I enjoyed it as much as the second one. And I think that's because I was so into the future stuff growing up. And when I bought these on VHS, it was the box set. It was the three movies and then the Secrets of the Back to the Future, hosted by noted kook Kirk Cameron. When I had that box set, and that box set was kind of, it was actually filmed on the Old West set, where the noted kook was a cowboy. I don't know if he was a cowboy, but that's where he was most of the time, answering what I would assume was are fake letters to be talked about during, to ask questions about the Back to the Future. But anyway, I think I would put that tape on sometimes, but for the most part, I would put on one and two and one and two. And yet in college, we did do a three-night showing of one, two, and three, I think, right, Jay? I feel like by the third one, we were like, yeah, we'll do it, or we can go play Mortal Kombat and listen to The Chronic. But I'm pretty sure we did it. So, but years on, I watched those two on VHS way more than I watched the third one, because I definitely brought the box set with me to college. And then I got the box set on DVD for Christmas. I believe my brother got that for me as well. And I don't know why I talk like this. And again, I watched The Secrets. I watched the first one more, watched the second one more. And I just never went back to the third one as much. So I'm telling you today, when I watched it, and believe me, I'll be watching it a lot, 31 times. But this was the first time I've watched this movie all the way through in years. And that's a shame. That's a gosh darn shame. And I apologize for getting so explicit with my language. It's just sometimes emotions run high. Another thing I did. So a couple of years ago, I had now my computer doesn't even have a DVD player. I had a computer with a DVD player. And I had a program on there that you could take the DVDs and turn them into digital video files or digital audio files. So I actually took the first Back to the Future and the second Back to the Future, and I turned them into MP3 files that I put in my, at the time it was Google Music, now it's YouTube Music, but it's in the cloud. So on my phone, I have the full audio track of the first movie and the second movie. So what I would do, and I haven't done this in a while, and I should, was I would take the movies and I would hit play and I would just listen to them, fall asleep, listen to the first one. And I think my whole hope, and still holds out, is that I would dream that I was in the movies. I might have had a dream that I was watching the movie once, but I'm not sure. Because sometimes I listen to music and the music becomes the soundtrack or becomes part of my dream. And it's only happened a couple of times, but it's so cool when it does. But it's never, I don't think it's ever happened with one and two. Here's the thing. I never did it for three, and that computer is so old. I don't even know if I could do that now. I have three on DVD. I have all three still. I still have the DVDs, but I never did the audio digital transcription. Now I own all three, on streaming or whatever you know, online digital. So I own them, quote unquote. I can watch them wherever I want. And I bought this, but I didn't buy them years ago. I didn't buy the trilogy because I had them on DVD. What I would do is I bought the first one just in time for Marchy McFly, same with part two. And then part three, I just bought a few months ago when it was on sale. And also I have an Android phone and we have this thing, it's called Google Rewards, where you just hit a bunch of, it asks you like, oh, did you go shopping here? Have you ever been here? Oh, did you buy anything? Like it gives you little surveys where they basically are tracking every step I make, but you get money for them. You get like 10 cents here, 20 cents here, 40 cents here. You don't think about it. It adds up. All of a sudden you have $20. Boom, you go buy Back to the Future 3 for free. And now I own the trilogy once again. And I have it on Google Play Music, Movies, or whatever the hell it's called. But I also belong to, is it called Movies Anywhere or Movies Anytime? Where they connects all the main all the main distributors like Apple, Amazon, maybe Vudu. So if you buy it in one of those places, you can watch it on any of those places. I don't know why I'm saying that, but basically I'm saying that's why I bought it. I buy everything on Google and, because I don't want an Amazon library. I just want everything in Google because hopefully they won't take that away, even though Google loves to make things and take things and move things and change things. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. Oh, is the so I finally own it on digital. Today's the day that I watched it for the first time. And look, I want to get more in the nitty-gritty over the next month, over the next 30 days, 31 days, including today, about things that I go, huh. And I know there's one big one that really, I wouldn't say it always was like, that makes no sense. There are definitely things that I said, well, wait a second, if this happened, wait a second, if that happened, like there are definitely things that I have to try to either justify or just call out for being, you know, incorrect. I don't know. But for the most part, what I liked about this movie is it's more reminiscent of the first one. You're in one place, you have one adventure, and you have one goal. Where the second one was so convoluted as far as you have to go this place to take care of this. That didn't work. I mean, it made it for more of like a madcap adventure. Oh no, we now have to go back here. And the idea of having to relive the first movie, I think, was always a really cool concept. I think the Back to the Future 2, which is most known or best known for the future. The future was to me, looking back, the least successful part of it. Back to the Future 3, we spend some time in, you know, 55, but we really, and we get back to 85, but the real thing is, you know, all set in the West, and it's all logically in order. Here we go. You know, this is what needs to happen. Here's how we're going to do it. We need to figure it out. Now there's some monkey wrenches thrown in along the way, but that's part of the fun. That's part of the story. It actually is part of the character development. And what I can say about these movies is, to me at least, I feel like all three stick the landing. Now, I don't know what it was. If it was me, or if it was the movie, if it was just the fact that, you know, that, excuse me, I'm trying to suppress yawns, that, you know, this is the kind of an end of an era for these characters, for in the film sense, at least. I got a little choked up at the end of this movie. Was when, I think it was when, right when Marty said, are you going back to the future? Now, they said back to the future many times in this movie. But he said, you going back to the future? And he goes, I've already been there. And then the train picks up. It got hover converted, and it picks up to take off. And again, I found something there that I said, wait a second, that doesn't seem right. Well, I'll talk about that much more. We have a lot to cover, and we have a lot of time to do it. But at the end, he takes off, and it flies off. Marty and Jennifer are watching, and we just get the end, and it just felt so finite because that is 33 years ago, and it really was the end. Now it's been repackaged, it's been here's a Blu-ray version, here's a Super Blu-ray version, here's a Greenway version, you know, HD, DVD, VHS, all kinds of versions coming out. We've had reunions. There's been recent reunions. We've had comic books. We've had cartoons. We have a musical. What's crazy is today, the musical was talked about being on Broadway, and was it Good Morning America or The Today Show? One of those did a little piece on Back to the Future, the musical, today. And I'm thinking, how is this, my country, 'tis of thee, today? How is this, like, how is this happening now when I just chose March and as a month? That's the only reason I was like, I want to do something in March. I chose March because of the name Marchy McFly. Nothing to do with Back to the Future. And it's not like this is a Back to the Future month. I mean, this movie takes place primarily in September over a couple days. And I feel like, is this the shortest amount of days that we cover? Because the first one's a week. The second one, though, is kind of weird because you're you're here for a day, you're in 85 for only a day, and then you're in 55 for a day. So that might be, that one's pretty short too. Oh no, 55, you're a little, no, I think it's one long day. But this one, you're there for a weekend, pretty much. But I have no idea what the hell I was talking about. I completely lost. I was saying that, you know, it has nothing to do with, it's in September. I don't know why, but I feel like, to me, all of a sudden I'm noticing things in March about Back to the Future. Like, why is this being announced in March? It's crazy. It's like when I bought my car, all of a sudden I see more versions of my car on the road. I think I'm just noticing it more. And maybe I'm just noticing things more about Back to the Future today in the last few days. But I even said to my wife, look at this. This is being promoted today. And I tweeted, they're celebrating Back to the Future, Marchy McFly as well. And a Back to the Future musical liked my tweet. I don't know if it's the official. I think it's just like a fan tweet, but very cool. Very cool. And speaking of Twitter, you can find me on Twitter at Geek Mentality. You can find me on Instagram at Geek Mentality. I think I'm done. I think this is just day one. I just want to talk a little bit about the movie and a little bit about how, you know, the one thing I did notice was that I did tear up at the end. And whatever you think of these three movies, you know, one being fantastic, and then two and three being their sequels of various degrees. Rotten Tomatoes agrees with Jay and myself that three is superior to two. I apologize to Back to the Future Part Three for taking so long to do it. But whatever you think of these three movies, I feel like all three of them stick the landing of the finish as far as giving you something to like get excited about. And like not a twist, but like a little, it's a surprise, I guess. The two, I mean, look at the first ending, amazing. If there was nothing that ever happened after that, amazing. The second ending, I is one of my favorites of any movie ever. I'll admit it. Like that ending, I could watch that over and over again. It helps because it's using my favorite movie and adding like to it. And then this ending is just such a cool closing out of the characters. But at the same time, you feel like this isn't the end because, you know, we see Doc, the whole movie, he wants to destroy the DeLorean. And at the end, he decides to make a new time machine out of the train and travel all over space and time, or I guess just time. And you feel like he'll be checking in on Marty for years to come. Did I ever talk about my script for Back to the Future Part 4? I think I only got through one page, but I always had this idea in my head. Maybe I'll talk about it. Maybe I've talked about it before. Maybe I'll talk about it again some other time, but that time will not be today. So, my friends, I want to say to you, thank you so much for listening. Thank you so much for coming back. This podcast is very erratic. You know, there'll be a month where you get an episode every day, and then you won't hear from me for months. But that's what Geek Mentality is. It's kind of my little home for these miniseries that I like to do. And, you know, Movie Month will be back for its 10th year in June. Sitcom All Ye Faithful will be back for its third year in December. I still want to go back to my Batman and Superman movies that I haven't done. And of course, this is the third year of Marchy McFly, but this is only day one. We'll be back for many, many more days, 30 more days, in fact. That's how March works. So yeah, we'll be doing this again tomorrow, and I hope you will join me tomorrow as well. But until then, my friends, thank you again for listening. Thank you again for subscribing. And you know what comes next, right? Here is my theme song. This is my podcast. I made it. Geek Mentality's what I named it. And I think you should listen and subscribe. Because I'm kind of funny and awesome. I think that I'm worth your time, and I'm kind of handsome. My mom says, please listen and please subscribe. At least listen to this.
episode.
Fab's not experts.